Danny, so I've seen Sarth a few times, and I've seen you play friendlies with Sarth.
Yeah,
how
he's really good. Okay. He's been getting better, and I think with, like, the upcoming, you know, with Smashville and stuff, he's just going to take a little bit of practice to do. But he was listening to a lot of my advice, which was, you know, originally in previous locals, which was, you know, got to start tomahawking, stop approaching with aerials so much, because I'll just shield and grab him. But okay. So that's been improving. Magic also on the come up here, trying to push his way on to winner's round three.
Dude, Magic last weekly, dude. Fucking
went off, dude. He went off.
Just love the
He did that against me earlier in friendlies. Cheesed him, bro. The stage is broken. So Magic also was telling me earlier about how he dislikes Hazards On. Which, granted, by the way, if anyone else is watching this, we're doing tests. Our weeklies aren't big enough to do anything crazy, so we're just testing out Hazards On and stuff. So a lot of people seem to like it. A lot of people see it. It's mixed.
It's,
I think,
mixed,
it's honestly
right? Right now it's mixed.
It's,
yeah,
something you got to get used to, like, honestly. So, but right now we're seeing probably the most neutral stage, in my opinion, because it doesn't move. It doesn't do anything. It hurts my eyes when someone goes to the last stock. You know, I
oh, the freaking thing just goes
oh,
on
eyes,
you.
Dude, my eyes. I can't see. It's too much moving. Too bright.
Oh, my God, dude. Yeah, also me and Cody X agreed. You're like, hollow? And you're like, hollow.
Yeah, it seems to be the most neutral stage, which I'm fine with, because it's just non-moving Smashville, which I think prompted a lot of the argument, and which is kind of the reason why we're doing a test on this, because not a lot of people kind of are, because they have bigger weeklies than we do. The argument is that we should make Hollow Bastion legal. But then the argument again is, well, then what happens to Smashville? So this is why people are like, okay, well, we can do Hazards On Smashville now. Now we have like seven stages, and it makes it fair. So I think it all come down to, I think end of the day, nice narrow ledge. Magic's staying at 100%, which is kill percent, if Sarth can hit that confirm. Oh, just...
Howard.
But either way, I think it might come down to us having hazards, unless some super jank happens that someone says this is why we don't make it. What? Oh, my eyes. Do my eyes now, my eyes. And then the ugliest background of all time appears.
Oh, no, it's pretty.
Who is
it?
Who is it? Who is it? It's,
I find it pretty.
Where's Mickey and Donald there, bro?
Where's Mickey and Donald? Where's Donald? Where's Goofy? Where are they?
And there's that lady.
Pretty lady. Pretty lady.
So I love how it's a good indicator that someone's on the last stock, too.
Oh,
he
missed
that
re-grab.
He was ready for it, yeah. So I'm playing pretty good right now. I was warming him up a bit. He's getting ready. Magic be playing Lucina, which is one of those heavier characters that's going to kind of fall into a lot more of Sarth's grabs and typical Sheik combos. Oh, no throw. Grab release?
Okay. Ooh, oh,
he's
boy.
He's invincible in the beginning of it for some reason. Okay.
Nice
right.
Catch.
All right. Magic at 55 isn't too bad of a deficit here. Sarth's definitely going to have to kind of work for this kill a little bit, since Sheik's got to, you know, work. All Magic has to do is swing that sword.
Yeah, good dash attack. Crazy.
Yeah, he's doing a really good job. I don't know about that. That covers... You can just time it right and get on stage, but that kind of puts you in a situation where Sarth can just kind of read your getup. But it's tough because you can jump over it, you can do most things through it if you know the timing on it. I was neutral getuping through it, so. Down tilts. He's having trouble finding this confirm.
Yeah.
Magic's doing a great job smash DI-ing out. Okay, good mash out. Oh, no, he's good.
Oh, he's good. Okay. One more hit.
He's just nearing ledge. Yeah. Sheik having one of the highest jumps off ledge. That's really good. And I know Sarth likes to jump off ledge a lot too, so it's really good for him.
Missing the tech.
That was super unexpected. That was really good, actually. Sarth going up with game one here.
Game one.
Excuse me?
Game effing freaking fire truck.
Fire truck. So let's see where Magic feels like taking Sarth. Especially with these new rules that he kind of despises. Hey, it all comes down to it. You'll figure it out, right?
Oh, yeah.
I feel like in something like this, yeah, you want Town City, yeah.
There
but
we go.
With Sarth, and Town City's pretty good for Sheik, especially when those platforms meet in the center.
No, he doesn't know. He doesn't know.
But it all comes down to it. I think we've seen it probably better on stage.
Okay.
Ready to smash?
Here we go.
We should give balloon pops. You know, whoever gets the most balloons pops.
That's what I did in my matches.
Yeah, dude, the balloon is hype.
Especially with projectiles.
All right, getting into it here. Game two. Magic counterpicking him to Smashville. We're having no DSR here as well, since there's seven stages to pick from, which is huge.
What's DSR?
Dave Stupid rule, meaning you can't go back to the stage you want on. Implemented in Melee, because Mewtwo King would keep going back to FD, fighting against foxes, even though he won there. Yeah. So it's kind of one of the main reasons they introduced it. And in games with like less stages, it kind of became more prevalent.
Okay.
Magic's doing a great job keeping Sharth away, which is probably the biggest part of this matchup. You don't want Sheik to get in, use her disjoints, and then all of a sudden do that. He's also tearing his combos really well. Double jab. Down tilt. Uh-oh. He caught him at the beginning of his up beat. That's really actually impressive.
Goddamn, mesmerized.
Just like, oh, what happens next? What are they gonna do?
Because I don't know much of the Sheik, neutral game.
Sheik's gonna be. That was cheeky. Sheik has a lot of these weaker hits, but with drag down up air and a lot of different confirms like that, it'll kind of be able to catch magic. Oh, the balloon pop hype! Oh, hop the balloon hype! But Sheik is extremely good at ledge guarding, drop zone nair, light hit a back air jumping off. It's so good. And Sheik is also invincible in the startup of her up B, so she could use that to her advantage. But it's kind of hard to edge guard Sheik as well, because when she's like that on the ledge, she can jump, and that was actually really great coverage. But I guarantee you,
he's trying to go for the puppy. He's trying to.
I think he didn't want that. I think he went to bouncing fish the other way to get out of his position. Magic's so good on the ledge.
Yeah, his ledge game is bonkers.
Yeah, right. That was a good jump. Falling fair. That's your stock. You are dead. Bam.
No.
See ya. 3-1. Stage pick working out really well in Magic's favor here. He's not allowing Sarth to be able to get to that platform as easy. Oh, yo, we got the melee ledge hogging here. Refresh the invincibility, bro. Sarth's got to find a way to get this kill. The hardest part with Sheik is finding that kill. You need to be confident with your confirms. You'll get these drag down, get these throw commands, and all that stuff.
Jeez, too high to kill.
Uh-oh. Oh, that was really smart dropping through the platform. Magic's just so good at hunting and just keeping Sarth out of his zone until Magic says, yeah, now I want you to go in so I can punish you. Oh, good read off the jump. Magic up with a 3-stock. Almost like he got a download, dude. I heard the Hall of Bastion fan, that's fair.
Fair enough.
See, that stage kind of worked out a little bit better. Magic, since I think Sarth banned FD, which means that it would, you know, when that platform kind of moves, it allows Sarth to keep magic away.
Yeah.
Because Sarth relies on a lot of the platforms. You know, tech chasing, drag downs, things of that manner. Alright, here we go. Getting into game 3 here. Winner this moves on, loser goes into losers. And Small Battlefield, not a bad pick here. We know how Magic likes his PS2, so. Oh, that's going to be a free grab. Oh, but he missed the up air drag down? Watch out here. These up airs are really working out in Sarth's favor. But Magic is just firing back and saying, okay, you'll hit me once,
yeah,
then
dude.
I'm going to hit you a second time, dude. Go away, Cody X. Yeah, so there's one up here. You want to do what I'm doing? That's what I thought. Go away.
I got no say in this.
Yeah, right?
Watch you two.
So, right now we're actually seeing really good neutral coming out from both Magic and Sarth. Sarth's looking for these kills. He's getting these combos he's looking for. Good rapid jab. But Magic, meanwhile, is going to get back to stage, and he's just going to hit Sarth back. He doesn't need to rely on big combos like Sarth does. He just needs to worry about these 1-2 hits he's going to be trying to get, and then that kill confirmed. Or even just the kill, for the heck of it. Oh, that's a back air.
Nice catch in the air.
Up air. Yeah, it's on, dude.
Yeah.
All right, Sarth up 3-2 currently, but he tried to call out that bouncing fish. You know he did. Sheik of Rage is a little bit interesting. A lot of her combos still are true, but she's kind of hunting for different ones when she gets more rage. See how that forward air didn't lean to grab this time? Yeah, because she's got more rage on it. Oh, that move is so good out of shield. Gotta be careful how you punish. And there's
that's it, yeah.
So, all right, well, Sheik's back down to 0. This could be big percent. Probably up to 80 even if Magic's not careful with how he DIs. Oh, good forward air to retaliate back. He definitely held out. He knew it was coming. That's cheeky. That's really cheeky.
Yeah, it's another get off in the option.
Pretty much. Which was a surprise because Sheik doesn't really have too many of those. She doesn't have as many disjoints as Sarth. Okay.
Bye, Misael. There he goes.
Bye-bye. Goodbye.
There he goes off to play his match. Now I got the real their commentator.
Hey, guys.
Than
it's Paco here.
I was just discussing about how this matchup's kind of both in each favor, but she kind of loses since.
Good edgeguard by Sarf there.
I was talking, but that was a good edgeguard. So Magic's kind of looking for these, you know, one hit kill confirms, forward air, nair, forward smash, while Sarf has to really kind of work against Sheik to get these combos going. You know, Magic doesn't need to worry about percent. He's just got to hit him. Oh, on the train, bro. 27 off
that.
Most characters do 27 in two hits, so that was four hits. But I don't like. What do you feel about people saying, "Oh yeah, she can't kill"? Because this is not true.
It's not true.
It's not. Oh, here we go. We're seeing big percent here coming 50%. Out.
50%.
Sorry, Magic might be on his way to an early losers bracket.
Ooh.
Up tilt.
Can't land right
platform?
Now.
Yeah, he can't. He can't get down.
No.
Which is completely different than what
Harry.
We saw the last game.
Oh, drag down.
Whoa.
Oh
that's
my
big.
God.
Whoa. He went for the needles too. He's expecting a DI down or something.
Ooh. Sarf looking like he's going to secure
Sarf
this right
is
now.
Sarf just walking back and forth saying, you have to approach me. You have to. Because you need this kill more than I do.
Magic going off stage. No.
And I think it's even better if Sarf dies here because then he won't have rage.
Drag
down up air and that's it.
Wow.
Sarf is playing hot, dude.
2-1 for Sarf.
2-1 over Sarf.
I believe that's a pretty big upset.
I think they're.